الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استقيموا واستووا راصوا واعتدلوا الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين إنا نحن نزلنا عليك القرآن تنزيلا فاصبر لحكم ربك ولا تطع منهم آثما أو كفورا واذكر اسم ربك بكرة وأصيلا ومن الليل فاسجد له وسبحه ليلا طويلا إن هؤلاء يحبون العاجلة ويذرون وراءهم يوما ثقيلا نحن خلقناهم وشددنا أسرهم وإذا شئنا بدلنا أمثالهم تبديلا إن هذه تذكرة فمن شاء اتخذ إلى ربه سبيلا وما تشاءون إلا أن يشاء الله إن الله كان عليما حكيما يدخل من يشاء في رحمته والظالمين أعد لهم عذابا أليما الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين إن للمتقين مفازا حدائق وأعنابا وكواعب أترابا وكأسا دهاقا لا يسمعون فيها لغوا ولا كذابا جزاء من ربك عطاء حسابا رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما الرحمن لا يملكون منه خطابا يوم يقوم الروح والملائكة صفا لا يتكلمون إلا من أذن له الرحمن وقال صوابا ذلك اليوم الحق فمن شاء اتخذ إلى ربه مآبا إنا أنذرناكم عذابا قريبا يوم ينظر المرء ما قدمت يداه ويقول الكافر يا ليتني كنت ترابا الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله، الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه، وبعد. We still with the story of سيدنا يوسف عليه السلام. And last night we stopped at
the dream.
ما شاء الله. Which dream? Which one? أي الرؤى؟ The ru'ya of the king. So the king of Egypt at that time. And you know, subhanallah, in the Quran, when it says al-malik regarding to Egypt is different when it says Fir'aun. Al-Fir'aun means he was Egyptian ruler, but al-malik, he was the from outside. So Egypt was under the rule of someone else at that time, and then the Egyptians kicked them out after that. So there is some history in there. So in al-malik is not an Egyptian title, Egyptian king, an Egyptian title for those who rule. So qala al-malik here, that means he was not Egyptian. That's why at that time Sayyidina Yusuf and all his brothers and everybody, they were the elite, right? So after that, when the Egyptians moved those out, they enslaved all Bani Israel after that. So this is a piece of history for everybody. So anyways, the king of Egypt at that time, he saw that dream. And in his dream, he saw 14 cows and 14 ears of wheat. Sanabil, sumbula. That's the branch of the wheat. He saw 14 of those. 7 of them, they are green. 7 of them are dry. And then 7 of the cows are fat. 7 of the cows are slender and slim. That's the first thing. Then he saw that those slim or starving cows are swallowing the fat ones whole, eating them. Cows don't eat cows, right? But in the dream, it has to mean something. So the king was like, this is a weird dream, this is a strange one. Then he gathered everybody around, all the sorcerers and the priests and his ministers and his cabinet, and everybody said, now tell me, what is this? Normally I don't see that, but this is something different. قالوا أضغاث أحلام. أضغاث أحلام. أضغاث is plural of ضغث. وخذ بيدك ضغثا فاضرب به ولا تحنث. This is mentioned in the Quran. Dighth means a bundle of different dry branches, right? Bundle. So someone is collecting those starter firewood, starter ones. So they don't look the same. There is no symmetry between them. There is different, right? So they are telling him, what you saw is like things that doesn't have any relationship with each other. That's what they mean, right? Adghathu ahlam, cow this, cow that. What is that? Nothing. Forget about it. Adghathu ahlam. وما نحن بتأويل الأحلام بعالمين. This is not our field. We like the big ones, the رؤيا, which is we can give you, but this one is no good. At that time, who remembered who was standing there? Who remembered? The one who was his cellmate. the cellmate who was giving the king now the drink, like he told him, that's what you're going to be. Said, Allah, subhanallah, I remember. I will tell you what is this mean. What this ru'ya mean? But send me to Yusuf in the prison. I know who is going to tell you exactly what this means. Right? So he remembered now, subhanallah. So he goes to him. And he tells him, Yusufu ayyuha as-siddiq. ودي جاي من واحد فاهم يعني. Yusufu ayyuha. Why he called him ayyuha as-siddiq? Why? Because he has an experience. He has an experience, right? You know, you told me and exactly happened. So you are Siddiq. And I saw you Muhsineen before. I told you are from Muhsineen and you told me exactly what happened. I forgot. I'm sorry, man. Yusuf Ayyuha Siddiq Aftina gave us the fatwa. And that tells us that for your fatwa, you have to trust someone. It's not anybody shopping, right? Some shopping. Well, whoever gives you what you like, it doesn't like that. It's not like that. Fatwa shopping is no good, huh? Yeah, you have to trust someone muhsin, someone siddiq, someone muttaqin, because he is going to sign from Allah Azza wa Jal. Giving you fatwa, he's making tawqi' from Allah Azza wa Jal. It's like someone have that power of attorney to give you. So you're trusting someone between you and Allah. It has to be bigger than your desire, right? So it is not about shopping here. It is about doing the right thing. So Yusuf wa Ayyuha Siddiq Aftina, not only me, the whole of the country need your help now, because the king is like that. Fi sab'i baqarat, and he told him, seven and all this. Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam told him, I have it. I will tell you exactly. And subhanAllah, in his ta'bir of al-ru'ya, in his ta'wil, he used the symbols in the dream plus a wahy from Allah. Two things. So the interpretation of the dream is one thing, but there, he added a part that does not have anything in the dream. Right? So he told him this seven cows, fat ones, and the 7 ears, that means there are 7 years, those cows means 7 years, that they have abundance in rizq, abundance in agriculture. And Egypt was an agriculture country, you know. So agriculture, you will plant all this wheat, which is the main crop at that time. So this is what it is. So the cows are the ears, and the wheat is what you are going to plant in 7 years. So you have 7 years, you'll have lots of rain, the land is good, no drought, nothing, beautiful. So use that. Use it. How you use it? You only consume what you are eating. And the rest, leave it in its branches and store it like that. So it does not get rotten or anything like that. So he told him, this is the first half. Then after that, 7 years will come with a drought. But you already saved, right? So you give him a 14-year plan now. So the next 7 years, they will be tough. Every year will be tougher than the one before. So, but if you do what I'm telling you in the first seven, those 7 will be okay. And actually, that's what happened. Not only the drought was in Egypt, was everywhere around. You know, in Iraq and Syria and Palestine and all of that, there were drought. So they not only helped themselves, but they helped all the countries around them because of the Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam and his interpretation. So Sayyidina Yusuf, and that tells you the victory of Allah. He was transgressed and he became patient. Subhanallah, Allah give him izzah, not only to prove his own innocence, but he helped humanity. You see, when you are with Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah give you that power, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, you know, he told them this 7 years, well, you take from it. So تَزْرَعُونَ سَبَعَ سِنِينَ دَأَبًا. دَأَبًا يعني دَأْبُكُمْ. في قراءة ابن كثير دَأْبًا يعني دَأَبًا ودَأْبًا, both are قراءة. So that means as you are doing. The only thing, you have to manage the storing and the consumption. يعني don't act like as if there is no tomorrow. No, there is 7 years coming, so you have to be ready for them. And then after those 7 hard years go away, that is the part of wahy now, which is not in the dream, right? ثُمَّ يَأْتِي مِن بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ عَام, the year number 15, فِيهِ يُغَاثُ النَّاسِ, rain will come, heavy. وَفِيهِ يَعْصِرُونَ, العصر, يعني squeezing, يعني making juice out of grapes, out of fruits. That means there is abundance, not only in the vegetable, because al-asr hada, asr al-fawakih, يعني of the fruit, and the fruit is the extra part. That means it will be that much, يعني, right? That year will be that much. Now he took that dream and he goes where? Sayyidina Yusuf did not tell him this time, and don't forget to tell the king to release me. He learned the lesson, right? before before he told them, remember, and he forgot, right? So now he's staying where? In the jail. He told him the dream and left him. So he goes to the king and tell him, he said, who told you this? I need him. Bring this man here. Right? Bring him here. So he goes to him back. They send him somebody back. Tell him, the king wants you. He said, no, I don't want to come out. Unless. Yes? First, I want to prove my innocence. طبعاً the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in hadith narrated in Musnad Ahmad, if I were in Yusuf's place, I would have responded and went out. I wouldn't make conditions. If they tell me to come out, I'll come out. And that shows us how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you are invited to something good, follow it. Right? You come later. Yourself come later. But anyways, that's what was his condition, Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam. So he said, prove. So the king said, all right, what happened? He said, oh, those ladies, bring them here. Bring the wife of Al-Aziz. At that time he died, her husband and all of that, you know, the age, you know, about 7-8 years passed. So he said, what happened to you with Yusuf? They said, wallah, he's innocent. We were wrong. And she said, I was wrong. And I did not accuse him. He is good. He's everything. And all this politics and all of that. And I confess he was right. I'm wrong. That's clear now. So they go to Sayyidina Yusuf, tell him, said, now I come out. You see, subhanallah, al-jail, he was put in the well against his will. And then Allah Azza wa Jal bring him out. Right? And then he was, you know, tested in his honor, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him, but he went in jail. And he went in jail and he helped someone, and then he helped the king, helped the country. Then Allah Azza wa Jal bring him out to become the top, the leader, the minister of all finances and of all of this. Subhanallah, arzaq of Egypt, ij'alni ala khazain al-ard. So the king told him, what you want? And now he said, make me the one who manage this. And subhanallah, this is the izzah of Allah. He gives to the one who is patient. Taman, we have a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, thalathun uqsimu alayhin. Three things I make oath on their validity. Ma naqasa malu abdin mu'minin min sadaqah. Abadan wallahi. Sadaqah is always will increase your money, not decrease. Don't look at the physical aspect of it. You have 100, you spend 10, there is 90. La. You still have the 100, but 10 of them went somewhere else, but they are yours. Right? So don't think that they left you. Actually, those are the ones that stayed. These 90, you don't know what you're going to do. Until you spend them, they are yours. They are not yours until you spend. You understand what I'm saying here? The money that you have in your bank account is not yours. When the money become yours? When you spend it. You spend it to eat, that was yours. Because you have food in your stomach now. This is mine because I'm wearing it now. Okay? The car is mine because I'm driving it now. If I paid it off, of course. You know how it is. The house is not yours, yani that we can prove it in different ways. Okay? So the money is yours when you spend it and you benefit. That becomes yours. And I'm not saying that. Rasul Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ فَمَالُ أَحَدِكُمْ مَا قَدَّمْ وَمَالُ وَرَثَتِهِ مَا أَخَّرْ. The money that you have in your checking and saving and 401k and all of this, this is the money of your heirs, the ones who will inherit. You just being the gatekeeper, you're just keeping it for them, counting it, بستفها كده تحطها في الرف, you know. You are just making sure that the money is there for someone else. So good, good job. You are doing a great job in that. All of us, mashallah, right? So all this money you are saving, you are making sure that it's good for them, right? But that $10 you put in the masjid, that's yours. Your name is on it. Huh? Your name is on it. That sadaqah, your name is on it. The money that you spend in the grocery, your name is on it. That the money that you give to your spouse, your name is on it. The money that you bought something for your children, your name is on it. So the money you spend on yourself, the money you spend on your family, and the money you give sadaqah, that's your money. But the money which is not spent, don't ever think it is yours. You are just keeping it for someone. So make sure it is from halal and make sure they are going to spend it in halal. Yeah, صحيح. مالو أحدكم ما قدم ومالو ورثته ما أخر. So the money you're keeping is not your money. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying that. So the first thing, ما نقص مالو عبد المؤمن من صدق. Second one is what? Who can remind me with this hadith? ما نقص مال عبد مؤمن من صدقة وما فتح عبد باب مسألة إلا فتح الله عليه بها باب فقر والعياذ بالله. So nobody asking or begging without need except Allah will increase his poverty. So if you have, say Alhamdulillah. Don't ask some people for help if you don't need it. It is not just let me accumulate if free money coming, let me take it. Doesn't work like that. So be careful. And the third one here, which is the proof of story of Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam, وما ظلم عبد مظلمة فصبر عليها إلا زاده الله بها عزة. الله أكبر. Nobody is transgressed or oppressed or right is taken and he or she practice the sabr from Allah عز وجل, practice the sabr except Allah will increase their dignity in this dunya before akhirah. Allah will increase their dignity, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will give them the izzah. But they have to stick with Allah. Don't change your principle. Don't compromise, right? So things go. People, king, tomorrow not king. People rich, tomorrow is not rich. You are young, tomorrow is old. So depends, but don't change your principle. So this is what we learned from this story. And inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, for the last chapter, tomorrow inshallah, from the story of Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam, may Allah Azza wa Jalla make us among those who listen and follow the best of what they listen to. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa barik ala Muhammad wa alihi wa sallam.